Hi everybody, welcome to another Yarn Scrap Friday, and this week I'm going to show you how to make some adult socks. And these socks are, I'm going to show you how to make them for different sizes in the length, but you're going to be needing two colours, and the main sock colour and then these colours to just add a little bit of interest. So we're going to be using a grey and a white for the other one of these socks. Both feet are the same pattern. And this is a DK light worsted weight yarn, so it's a yarn weight of 3. And this is our Happy Berry Baby Snuggles DK yarn, which you can get on our website for a limited time only. Let's throw that in there. We're going to be using a 4mm G crochet hook, and it's a good idea to have a pair of scissors and a yarn needle as well for sewing in those ends. Okay, so this pattern here, we're going to start off with the grey. We're going to start at the toes. And this pattern here is, this is designed for teens to adults. And this specific sock, specific sock here. This sock here is a size 6 to 7, UK size 6 to 7. However, I'm not going to show you specifically how many rows to do, because what I want you to do is actually measure it for your foot. But I will say how many rows I did for a UK size 6 to 7, just so that you can do less rows or more rows, depending if you're making it for somebody else and you're not using yourself to measure it on. But we're going to start off with at the toes, and the first thing to do is to chain 9. So you want to chain 9 to begin. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And 9, so you want to chain 9, and then we're going to do 2 single crochet in our second stitch from hook. Now our second stitch, we don't count the loop that's on our hook, there's our first stitch there, and our second stitch is there. So in that second one, we're going to do 2 single crochet, but when I go into it, I'm just going underneath that one bit of yarn, and there's a reason for that. It's so we can easily see the chain when we want to work back into it again. All will become clear. But in there, in our second stitch from hook, we're going to do 2 single crochet. So go back in again and do another one. So you've got 2 in there. Then we're going to do 1 single crochet in the next 6. And again, when I go into the next chain, I'm just going underneath one bit of yarn. So 1 single crochet in the next 6. So that's 1. And then next stitch, 2. Next stitch, 3. Next stitch, 4. Next stitch, 5. And the next stitch, 6. And that should leave you with 1 chain at the end. Just 1 left. And that last one, we're going to do 2 single crochet. So go into that last one and do 2 single crochets. So it's 1, go back in and do another one, so you end up with 2 in there. Okay, so by the end of that first row, you should have 10 stitches. Okay, 10 stitches. So then what we're going to do is we are going to, my yarn's just fallen on the floor, we're going to work back into these chains again in the opposite direction. So we just turn it round clockwise. And because we only went under that one piece of yarn, it means that we can easily see the chains on the other side when we work back into them again. So we're going to start off in the first one, which is exactly the same stitch as the last one we worked into. We're going to do another 2 single crochet. So go back into that last stitch again and do another 2. 1 and 2. So technically you end up with 4 single crochet in that last stitch. And then turn your work clockwise like that. And you can work the tail end in as well as you go down. But you want to find the next chain, and hopefully you've worked just underneath one bit of yarn, which allows you to see, get that tail end out of the way, allows you to see that stitch fairly clearly. So I'm going to go into the next chain. And I've done a video in more detail on working into your foundation stitches, so I shall put a link to that in the description. I'm going to do one single crochet in the next six again, which just mirrors the opposite side. So one, then in the next chain, two, okay, next chain, three, next chain, four, next chain, five, and then the next chain, six. And then that leaves you with one at the end there, and then that last chain we're going to do two single crochet again. So into that last chain, do two single crochet, one, and back in again for two. Okay, so you've done 10 stitches in the opposite direction as well, working back into those foundation chains again. So all in all, from the first row and then the second row, we've now got 20 stitches in total, and now we're going to be working in the rounds. We're just going to be going round and round and round rather than back in rows. So what you want to do now is to slip stitch in that end stitch. So that very very first single crochet that you did, we're going to go into there, it's right at the tip of your circle. I'm going to put our hook in there. We're just going to do a little slip stitch. A little slip stitch. And that just gets our project at the end, right at the top there. And then what we're going to do is we're going to chain two. Chain two, one and two. And we're going to count that as a half double crochet. So you're going to count that as a stitch, those two chains, half double crochet. Then in the next stitch round, this one here, we're going to do three half double crochets. So we yarn over, go into that next stitch and do three half double crochets. So the whole of this sock pretty much is made up of half double crochets. So one, then back into the same stitch for another, two, then back into the same stitch again for three. Okay, so you've got three half double crochets in that next stitch. And then we're going to do one half double crochet in the next seven along the edge. So one half double crochet in the next seven. So there's one, and then the next stitch, two, the next stitch, three, just pull through all three, next stitch, four, next stitch, five, the next stitch, six, and then the next stitch, seven. And if you're new to crocheting, it's probably a good idea to check out my beginner stitch tutorials and then coming back, so you get really good at doing the half double crochet. Then the next stitch on the corner again, we're going to do three half double crochets in there. Okay, so go into that next stitch, and we're going to do three half double crochets. So there's one, then back into the same stitch for another one, two, then back into the same stitch again for another one, three. So you've got three in that corner stitch. Then we're going to do one half double crochet right at the top, just one half double crochet. Then on the next corner, we're going to do three half double crochets again. Three, so one, then back into the same stitch, two, then back into the same stitch, three. So you've got three half double crochets in that corner stitch. And then we're going to do our one half double crochet in the seven along the edge. So one half double crochet in the next seven, one, next stitch, two, next stitch, three, next stitch, four, next stitch, five, next stitch, six, next stitch, seven, and then in the next stitch on the corner you want to do finish up with three half double crochets. So the next stitch you want to do three, so one, and back into the same stitch, two, back into the same stitch, three. Okay, then it looks like you've got another stitch. It looks like you've got another stitch there, but that's what I call a fake stitch. That's just tricking you. That's not a real stitch, because just above that is your chain two, which we're counting as a stitch, and you want to slip stitch into that second chain. So there's our first chain and there's our second. So we're just going to slip stitch into there. One and two. For some reason it's gone really difficult on me. There we go. Slip stitch into there as best you can to join the round. Okay, so by the end of that round you should have 28 stitches. Okay, and it should look a little something like that. And if you're making this for someone with a wider foot than, so say for a man, he might have a slightly wider foot than a female, you might just want to just add a couple of chains. So you might, instead of doing 9, you might want to do 11, and then follow the same system with the increases on the corners, and then just add your stitches on the length there. But this should quite comfortably fit sort of average lady's size when talking about the width of the foot. We'll come to the length in a minute. Then what we're going to do is we're going to chain 2, 1 and 2, and again count that as a stitch. We're just going to do one half double crochet in each stitch around. So we're going to keep a stitch count of 28. So just go into the next stitch, which is there, and do your, oops, that hasn't gone in properly. So I always try and go under two bits and then have, go under two bits of yarn and then have, you can see you've got one bit underneath as well, so you're actually going through something. So I'm going to do one half double crochet in the next stitch and then one half double crochet in each stitch around, so you've still got a stitch count of 28 including your chain two. Okay, so I'm just going to do that and then I shall come back. Okay, so I'm just coming up to the last stitch, the last half double crochet. And there's our little fake stitch. Always looks like there's an extra stitch at the end, but that's a fake stitch. And just next to that is our chain two. So there's our first chain, there's our second. So you want to slip stitch into that second chain, top of our chain two. To join the round. Okay, so you should still have a stitch count of 28, and you should start to see that it's sort of bending a bit like that because you haven't done any increases on that round. And you want your project to bend that way. This is our right side and this is our wrong side. You can tell because that's got the tail. We want that to be on the inside of the sock. So you want to bend it in such a position that your tail end is on the inside. We're going to be making our sock in that direction. Okay, so what we're going to do now is we're going to do another little increase round just to get this a little bit wider. And we're going to chain two again, one and two. And then we're going to do one half double crochet in the next two. So one half double crochet in the next stitch. Then one half double crochet in the next stitch. And then we're going to do two half double crochet in the next stitch. So in the next stitch we're going to do two half double crochet. So there's one, and then we go back into the same stitch and do another one. So you've got two in there, so a little increase of two. Then we're going to do one half double crochet in the next nine along the edge. So one half double crochet in the next nine. So that's one. Next stitch, two. Next stitch, three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. And nine, and then we're at the corner and we want to do two half double crochet in the next stitch. So in the next stitch we're going to do two half double crochet, one and another one in the same stitch, two. Then we're going to do one half double crochet in the next three, just along the top. So one half double crochet in the next three, so that's one, and then the next stitch, two. Then the next stitch, three, just along the top edge. Then we're going to do two half double crochet on the corner. So in the next stitch, we're going to do two half double crochet, one and another one in the same stitch. So you've got two in there. Okay. Then we're going to do one half double crochet in the next nine along the edge. So one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, and nine. Sorry about the background noise. And then we're going to finish up in the last stitch there with two half double crochet. So one and another one in the same stitch. And then it looks like we've got another stitch there, but that's our little fake stitch. So we want to slip stitch in the top of our chain two. There's our first stitch. There's our second chain. So we want to slip stitch into there. To join the round, do a little slip stitch. And your stitch count now should be 32. So you should have a stitch count of 32 and it should look a little something like a little boat. Okay. And then what we're going to do is we're going to do 5, 6, 7, 8. So we're going to do four rounds of just chain two, one half double crochet in each stitch round, slip stitch to join. So you've still got a stitch count of 32. So you just want to chain two, whoops, one and two. Then do one half double crochet in that next stitch. You always want to make sure you get that next stitch because the top of the chain two and that first stitch are very close together. So you can easily miss that first stitch. You normally have to go into it a bit like a chain as well. So one half double crochet in that next stitch, then one half double crochet in each stitch around. So you've still got a stitch count of 32 and you want to do this for four rounds. That's for rounds 5, 6, 7 and 8. Okay, so I'm going to do that and then I'm going to come back. Okay, so I'm just coming up to the very last stitch on the fourth round. And then we're just going to slip stitch to join. But before we do, I'm just going to stop there because we want to join the white when we slip stitch. So that now should fit comfortably over your toes. And if it's too, it should have a little bit of stretch in. So it should stretch just a little bit onto your toes. And if it's too small, then you might just want to, at the very beginning, just add an extra couple of chains, like I said, or if it's too big, and then you might want to just take off a couple of chains at the beginning, but follow the same method, increasing or decreasing stitches on the length to accommodate the pattern. But that should fit comfortably over your toes now. And what we're going to do is just join the white. So normally we would just slip stitch into the top of our chain two, and we're going to do that. So just find your chain two, but instead of yarning over with the grey, we're going to bring in our main sock colour, in this case our white. And then I'm just going to put the white tail end over my hook, and I'm just going to hold that into place there. And I'm going to bring that through my chain instead and slip stitch with the white. And now we're working with our white. So just pull your tail ends to secure that. Then we're going to do exactly the same. We just chain two, and then we work one half double crochet into each stitch around. So you go into that next stitch, do a half double crochet, and then do one half double crochet in each stitch around, just like you did before for these rounds. So you're just keeping a stitch count of 32, or however many stitches you are if you've adjusted the pattern. Now what you want to do is you want to continue that for as many rounds as you need to fit your sock. So here's my lovely drawing of a foot. Excuse my artistic abilities. But so far you would have made the front bit here. So you've done this bit. And you want to continue doing chain two, one half double crochet in each stitch around, and then slip stitch to join up to this point. So it's up to the ball of your foot and just before it starts curving up. So you want to just repeat it for however many rounds you need up to the ball of your foot. And if you're making for this for somebody else, you want them to measure from their big toe up to the beginning of the ball of their foot. You want that first measurement there. So, and for the size for a UK 6 to 7, just for reference, I did it up to rounds 31, so round 9 to 31, so that's 9, 10, 11, 12, all right, I've just worked that out. I did 23 rounds. If we bring back in our sock here, I just did one half double crochet in each stitch around, slip stitching on the top of our chain two. I did that for, oh, I've forgotten now, 23 rounds, let's just count. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 21, 22, 23. I did 23 rounds, and that got me up to the ball of my foot and the curve of my ankle. Okay, so you want to just do that, repeat that, and then I shall come back and show you what to do next. Okay, so just, you actually fasten off your grey as well. So, just to get that out of the way, tuck that inside. Those tail ends, and then just carry on doing your one half double crochet in each stitch around, because you don't need to increase to get it to fit the foot, because there is a slight elasticity in the crochet which accommodates the increase in size, so you don't need to worry about increasing. So I'm going to do that, and then I shall come back. Okay, so I'm just coming up to the last few stitches on the last round, 23rd round for my size. So just finishing up with one half double crochet in each stitch, and then we slip stitch in the top of our two chain. Finish that round. Okay, so I'm just going to pull that up a little bit, and then I will show you where this comes up to on the foot. Okay, so if I'm asking for any thumbs down on my video, it will now be when I actually show my foot on camera. But your slipper should, or your sock rather, should come up to the ball of your foot. So literally just before the ball of your foot. starts to appear, and you want it to come up to, it's about an inch or so, less than an inch away from your ankle, and it should just start to sort of bunch up a little bit. So you just want to catch it before it starts to bunch up, because if you kept going, that would start to bunch up like that. So you want it just before it starts to bunch up, about there. Okay, so just up to the ball of your foot. And now what we're going to do is move on to the next stage. So I'll put you back on the table and get rid of my foot. Okay, so when you've finished your last round and you're happy with your length, what we want to do is we want to turn our work, and just make a note of that last stitch you've just done there. You want to put your finger just over that last stitch. There's a reason for that. What we're going to do is we're going to turn our work, and we're going to start working in the opposite direction. So instead of working in this way, we're going to start working back on ourselves. And the reason I asked you to just put your finger over that stitch is because we want to avoid working into that first stitch. So going into that next stitch, that one there, we want to do a slip stitch. So one slip stitch. And then we're going to do a slip stitch in the next stitch. And then we're going to do a slip stitch in the next stitch. And then we're going to do a slip stitch in the next stitch. So you've done a slip stitch in the next four stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then what we're going to do, we're going to do the same thing again. We're just going to put our hand over that last, our fingers over that last stitch, so that one there. We're just going to put our fingers over there and then turn our work again. And then finding that next stitch that comes after, so that was the one we were hiding, finding that next slip stitch, we want to work into there. And we want to work into there a half double crochet foundation stitch. So this might sound a little bit complicated, but what first thing to do is just to yarn over and put your hook into that slip stitch. And the reason we've worked back in the opposite direction is just to get the project in the right position. So we want to yarn over and just put our hook into that next slip stitch. Bring the yarn through as normal. So you've got your three loops. There we go, as normal. And normally what you would do with a half double crochet is just yarn over and pull through all three. But we're doing a half double crochet foundation stitch. So to do that, we're going to yarn over and just pull through the first loop to begin. So basically do a chain into that first loop. So pull for that first loop. And you've still got your three loops, and then we do our half double crochet as normal. So we just pull through all three. And that's a half double crochet foundation stitch. And the reason for that is because we need to work 23 half double crochet foundation stitches. And we've just done our first one into that stitch. But the next one, we're going to yarn over. And when we did that chain one, we created a stitch on the side. So it might be a little bit hard to see, but just on the side where you did that chain one, you've created a stitch. Hang on, let's yarn over. We're going to put our hook into that chain one that we did, that extra little stitch. If I can get my hook in there. There we go. So it's just gone into that chain one that we did. And I've done a video in more detail on foundation stitches, like the double crochet foundation stitch and the single crochet. So I'll put some links in the description below if this is completely new to you and you're getting a bit lost. So you might want to go get your head around it a bit more. But we're going to do the same thing again. We'll do another half double crochet foundation stitch. So we're going to bring our yarn through that extra chain that we created, get our three loops, and do the same thing again. We're going to yarn over and create that little extra chain. So just bring it through the first loop. Then we've got our three loops. We yarn over, pull through all three to do a half double crochet as normal. And now you've created another stitch at the side, our second one. And we're going to yarn over and we're going to go into that next, that one we've just created there, like so, on the side. Do the same thing again, bring the yarn through, yarn over, do a little chain one, just bring it for that first loop first, and then do your half double crochet as normal, pull through all three. Now you've created another stitch on the side. As you can see, you're working up, upwards. So we're going to put our hook into that next one. Next stitch, bring the yarn through, create our next foundation chain, just pull through that first loop, and then pull through all three, like so. And we're going to continue doing this until we've got 23 of these half double crochet foundation stitches. But I'll show you the measurement and how it should fit around your foot as well. If this is really confusing you, what you can do is just do a slip stitch. We go back to here. We just do a slip stitch in the next three instead of the four, and then just chain 23 if you want to. You can do that as well. It won't make a huge difference. The reason I'm doing this is just to create a softer edge. So you can just chain 23, but don't do four slip stitches. Just do the three and then chain. Because the reason we did four here is because we've got the extra width of doing the foundation stitch. So I'm just going to continue doing this. I'm just going to yarn over, going into that side chain that we're creating by just pulling for the first loop, and create 23 foundation stitches. So just pull for the first loop, create that side stitch, and then do our half double crochet. And again, I'll put it into the next stitch on the side. Oops. Pull through and create the next stitch on the side, pull through that first loop, and then do our half double crochet as normal. So I'm going to continue this until I've got 23 of these. I've done 2, 4, 6, I think I've done 6 so far. We'll see. So we need about 23. Okay, so I'm going to do that and then I'll show you how it looks on the foot. I'll have to put my foot on camera again. No. Okay, so I finished creating my 23 half double crochet foundation stitches, but alternatively you may have done just some simple chains if you wanted to as well. So now I'm going to show you how this looks like on the foot. Okay, so it's around this side here, and this should now, if you have a look here, there are your foundation stitches, and there's the end of our yarn, and this should now wrap around your ankle. And it should, without stretching, come to your ankle this side, without stretching, because you want a little bit of stretch so it's not too loose, just to reach the sock. So you want to just, it should finish naturally without stretching, just by your ankle this side, starting from there, going round the back, there, round the back, at the top of the ball of your foot. And it should come to your other ankle without stretching, because you want to leave the distance between your ankle and the rest of the sock just to stretch it over to join. And that just means that it won't be too baggy when we come up for the rest of the sock. Okay, so what we're going to do now is we're going to join this to the rest of the sock. Okay, so I'm going to go back to the table.